Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer of metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to give you exposition of Matthew 19, marriage and divorce. There's one over there sentence which is very important. What God has joined together, man should not put it asunder. Now, there are two meanings of this one. One I did was this. The physical one, which is that when a baby is conceived in the womb of the woman, in which the soul, man, has joined with the flesh, wife, to make one person, so that should not, abortion should not be taking place. But more significant of that one is spiritual meaning, which is that man, in the beginning, remember that Jesus talked about the beginning. In the beginning, the people were in the company of God. And that company of God is when you have all the four qualities, conscience, then you have truthful, contented, and merciful. When all these four qualities are in you, then you are in God and God is in you. So that was the beginning, and as the deterioration took place and it brought to this stage of darkness, which is we call this present age, we call dark age, because the rabbi had also become blind to spirit. So then the Christ himself come, the royal priest of God. So he comes to establish the same thing as it was in the beginning. So in the beginning, as I did the Gospel of Philip, and which was very instructive, and that has changed my views on this parable. So in the beginning, the man is the Christ and the wife is the Holy Spirit, which is common sense. Now, when you subdue your wisdom to that of God, then you are a Christ, or you are solitary. So, Christ Jesus came to do the will of our Father, not his own will. So, when the man in you, which is called inner man, which is called Christ, is not dominated by any other person than the God, because the Christ is the royal priest of God. So when you do the will of our Father, then your wisdom stay virgin. Then because nobody else has influenced you. Nobody has taken away your wisdom. As the people follow Pope, and people follow the Billy Graham, and this and that evangelist, and anybody. Because in God, or in Christ Jesus, you need to be a solitary. Solitary with your Holy Spirit, your own wisdom, to be virgin. Virgin means only doing the will of our Father, not will of any man. So here next one is that what God has joined together, man should not put it asunder. Man means the one who has conscience. That person who has conscience, those who are come in the name of Jesus or the apostles, they should not put it asunder, mean that they should not influence the person and make a blind following. A person is killed when his conscience has been taken over by the other person, such as the Pope, you know, when he says, do this thing and everybody does it. Don't read more than these four Gospels, and any Gnostic Gospel or anything else, don't read it, don't follow it. When you do what you are told, then you are killed. Now Jesus described this killing through an analogy. A Samaritan was taking a lamb over his shoulder. And Jesus asked his workers, that Samaritan, he's taking the lamb over his shoulder, what he will do with it? Then the workers, they were not disciples, they were workers, laborers, the 12. Then they told Jesus that when he will rest at night, night mean darkness, daytime mean the light of God or light of Christ. So when he will rest at night somewhere, he will kill the lamb and eat it. Then Christ Jesus said, will he eat it if the lamb is still alive? They said, no, you can't eat it when the lamb is alive. It's only he can eat it when he has killed it. So this is the thing, you know, you get many people who influence you, who kill your conscience. They make a following. Remember, Jesus never sought a following. He himself was solitary. He made his laborers solitary. So he did not seek any following at all. So these people who are making following Pope and other people, these are televangelists and all that, they are the antichrist. They have nothing to do with the Christ Jesus. They have made their killing. So what God has joined together, man of conscience, would not put them aside, but the sons of Satan, the antichrist, they will put it aside. And after they put it aside, they will kill him and eat him. So once you keep alive spiritually, twice born, you go by the will of your Father, by the will of our Father, and you submit your conscience, your wisdom to the wisdom of our Father, and not to the wisdom of the Pope or any other person. So then you remain virgin, and then the Christ with you, Christ is the one who looks after the virgin. So if the virgin then go and person then go and follow somebody else and desert the Christ, then that is unfaithfulness. That one part I will come later on, but this is very important, that no son of man who is twice born, who has conscience, will make a following. It is only the sons of Satan who create darkness and who love darkness, that they make a following of the blind. Blind are those people who have been killed spiritually. Spiritually dead people. So that's why Jesus also said, where there are corpses, there are vultures. The vultures are these people who go make a following, who make the following of the dead people. For example, in Russia, you know, they have been, door has been opened, and you see how many people have moved to Russia, establishing their camps. Remember, these people who are here, these churches, they have different churches. When Jesus was a uniter and not a divider, it's only the Antichrist who is the divider. So when he was uniter, why do you have a Baptist church, Methodist church, Church of England, Church of Ireland, and all that? It all shows darkness. So these vultures are going to Russia to eat those dead people, make a following. in the name of Jesus. So in the name of Jesus, you have to make people